This is a Sony ZV-1 Mark II or the Sony ZV-1 Mark II.
This is the Nikon Z30 or Z30. Those were two videos, one of the Sony ZV-1 Mark II and the other one of the Nikon Z30 or Z30. If you've been looking for a digital camera to do vlogging or content creation or just for personal use, you might be considering the Nikon Z30 or the Sony ZV-1 Mark II, as I was considering both cameras for my use. And I thought I'd make this video to kind of give you just my overview of what I think between the two cameras and which one you might want to consider if you're looking at one of these. We're going to do an unboxing of the Nikon Z30. I've already done an unboxing of the Sony, and that's on my channel. But before we get started, please take a moment to like this video if you found it useful and subscribe to be notified when I post new videos. I try and do it a couple times a week, and some new exciting stuff coming your way. Let's get started. Okay, let's open this up. This is the Nikon Z30 with the DX1650 kit lens. And for all you unboxing fans, let's go all the way around here and look at everything. Sides of the boxes. We'll even show you the bottom of the box. And there it is. Let's open it up. Inside, we've got a USB-C to USB-A cable and some documentation. Lots of documentation. Looks like registration cards and instruction manuals, all that good stuff is all there. So I'll put that in a stack. And then let's get to the good stuff. Inside, we've got a Nikon strap if you need a strap for your camera. We've got the battery, one battery included. Probably need some additional ones, but one it comes with the camera. And then we're going to go to the camera body, open up the camera body, see what's in there. And I'm guessing it's probably just camera body. And it is. So, like a 35 millimeter type camera body, nice grip to it, easy to reach buttons. There's the display. Touchscreen display, which is really nice. You can flip that over and have the touchscreen accessible, or you can just flip it closed and have it not accessible while you're using the camera. Got a really nice feel to that camera. And then your kit lens, 16-50. Nice lens if you're just doing in-house content creation. This is a great lens to just kind of keep on hand. The nice thing about this camera, as opposed to the Sony, is you can switch out these lenses. So if you decide you need something else, you can purchase another lens and just put it on the camera body, and then you've got different focal lengths that you have available with different lenses that you keep. Lens goes on just with the white dot. You line them up on the camera body, and that's how you attach it. And then you just kind of give the lens a turn, and it'll click into place, and you've got your camera body there with the lens attached. So nice camera there. Put that down. Line everything up here. Nikon strap, the USB-A to USB-C cable, all your documentation, and your battery. So my overall thoughts and impression are a preference towards the Nikon Z30. I used to do a lot of photography, more amateur photography. I wasn't a professional photographer or anything like that. But I did photography. I had Canons and I had Nikons and Minoltas, the kind where you actually put film in the camera, those kind of old school cameras. So the Nikon Z30 just felt more comfortable for me. It felt like an actual camera. The Sony, and I've had compact cameras in the past as well. The Sony felt just more compact, and I actually liken it to cell phones, and in a reverse way, if you can believe that. If you've got two phones, one's a smaller phone, one's a bigger phone, you might find that when you're using a smaller phone, it just feels more comfortable. You can kind of do things, and it's easier to do one-handed operation type stuff on a smaller phone, where a big phone, like the iPhone that I've got,
It might be a little more clunky and it might be harder to use and use with one hand, but I feel that's the opposite with cameras. The Nikon felt like I could control the camera more and the buttons were a little more spread out and able to reach, where the Sony, I felt like I was using a small, a big cell phone where it was more clunky and the buttons were really small, if that really makes sense to you. I'm not sure if it does or not, but I found the Nikon just had a better feel grip to it. I do like the interchangeable lenses, where the Sony doesn't have interchangeable lenses. Quality wise, and there's lots of videos with specs and quality and spec comparisons and things like that, but the Nikon, I think they both give great pictures. I think I've got a video on the Sony that is I filmed with the Sony. I've got a video with the on Tempest apps that was filmed with the Sony. This one is being filmed with the Nikon. And I think the quality is on par for both. I think they're both great cameras, probably good values. The Sony is a little pricier than the Nikon. I think the Nikon's maybe has been out a little longer, but I think the Nikon as a use camera for vlogging and content creation, more for just at home use, is a better camera. Maybe if you're doing a lot of on the go vlogging and content creation, the Sony might be a better fit for you. So that's my take on the digital cameras. I hope this helps. Again, if you found it useful, please like this video and subscribe, and we'll talk to you later.